is Zanele Njapha, Unlearning Expert at Tomorrow Today Global. So we've established that in order for an organization to be future fit, resilient, confident about the future, and ready to innovate in a digital climate that changes faster than we can say the word change, this organization needs to have unlearning ingrained into the very culture of the organization. I love to say it's the DNA of the organization that needs to be all about unlearning. The best way I've heard unlearning being described before is as emptying your cup in order to allow your cup to be refilled. But let's just break this term down. What does it mean to unlearn? To unlearn is all about challenging perspectives that already exist and have been actually in existence in an organization for quite a while. This is why unlearning is so pivotal when it comes to learning, because we're not able to learn if there are ingrained concepts, models, skills, and even products, in a sense, that have been known to an organization and are not being challenged. So unlearning is all about creating that shift in the way we perceive our organization, the way we perceive our skill sets, the way we perceive our models that are perceivably working for us and maybe not. It's important to understand with unlearning that the reason why it's important to unlearn is because some of these skill sets, some of these models that we, strategies, tactics, and even procedures and processes are no longer serving our organizations. And not just not serving, but they can also be detrimental towards the goals that we set for ourselves, all because we are holding on to processes that are detrimental and are actually hurting us in the long run. Navi Rajo, who's actually an innovation facilitator and someone who helps organizations to innovate better and to create strategies that work in the future, he advises that unlearning and learning is all about a mix and actually more or less a balance between already existing expertise and purposeful naivety. It's about taking on a stance of being ready to learn more by emptying out, as I said earlier, your cup of the knowledge and the skill sets and all of the perceived values and even insights that no longer serve your organization in order to allow what is constant and is currently assisting other organizations and could assist you to be your primary standpoint in order to allow you to be future fit. Because if you don't empty out models that used to be effective 20 years ago, you will not be able to maintain your future fitness. A lovely example I love to use is one within sales. Your customer relationship management strategies must be geared towards the present, and not just the present, but the future. That's what I always advise when it comes to unlearning, is that most of your unlearning, actually about 25% or a quarter of your unlearning, needs to be future focused. Going back to that sales example, with your customer relationship management strategies, they need to speak to how we see the client and the customer in today's world. Have a look at about 20 to 10 years ago, when the customer was just seen as a mere receiver of our products and our services. Nowadays, however, and well into the future, the client is someone who participates as a co-creator in the buying process. So if your strategies, models, and even your products don't allow the customer to be someone who works with you, you are going to find yourself in a position where you are not future fit because you failed to unlearn. I look forward to working with you and your organization.